So here we are. It is day two of our prayer journaling challenge. And like I said yesterday, we're going to just really be focusing on lots of different ways you can use your prayer journal to connect with God, and the things that you find really resonate with you and are helpful for you in your prayers, you can keep doing on a regular basis. And the other things you can do maybe not so regularly, or you can just forget all about and focus on the things that are the most beneficial for you. So when we talk about prayer journaling, we are talking sometimes about lists. If you remember yesterday, we did like a list of the things that we were thankful for in our gratitude brain dump. Prayer journaling can also be more like letters to God, which is what we're going to be focusing on today. And before we jump in, I just want to encourage you to try not to self-censor. When we start this exercise, I would really encourage you to just write what comes to mind. Don't try to make it flowery or perfect handwriting or anything like that. God already knows your thoughts and He already knows what's going to end up on that page. And so you don't need to try so hard that you get kind of paralyzed. Sometimes we can do that. So if you have taken any of my other prayer courses, or maybe you have listened some to the Praying Christian Women podcast, where my co-host Jaime and I talk a lot about prayer, you may have heard me before talking about praying with your imagination. And if not, I just want to explain it a little bit. It might sound a little bit weirder than it is. Praying with your imagination really is just engaging all of your senses and your imagination while you're praying. So for example, if you're praying for a wayward child to come back to Christ, you're not just praying with your brain, "Dear God, please help my kid to stop being a prodigal." You're praying and envisioning with your imagination what it might look like when they do come back to Christ, when they have that passion for the Lord and all of that. It can give excitement to our prayers. And what I want to give you today for your prayer prompt is a question that you can kind of fill in the blank. So in your journal, notebook, Word document, whatever you're writing in, we're going to start just by saying, "God, if you hadn't saved me," and then you can use your imagination to kind of fill in the blanks. I'm not saying we're being absolutely prophetic and this is exactly how it would have looked, but it can help us to learn how much we do have to be thankful for and how much God did save us from. So for example, "God, if you hadn't saved me, I would be lost in a world of despair and depression or addiction or whatever." And then from there, you can stay on that topic, or really you can just let your letter to God take you wherever it is that you want it to go. I'm not going to set the timer this time. I'm just going to let you go for as long as you want. If you're the kind of person who does sort of like to have a time limit, you could set a timer for yourself, or you could do something like, "I know that I want to write one page," or something like that. You can figure out what's going to work best for you. So again, we're starting just with, "God, if you hadn't saved me," and then you get to fill in the blanks. And then after that, you can take your letter to the Lord wherever you want it to be. The purpose is to just have lots of different ways to connect with God. So as things come to mind, you can incorporate that into today's prayer journal exercise. And we'll see you tomorrow.